everyone! Yeah. I'm Rachel.
And I'm Paige.
Welcome to Time Machine Days, where we bring famous people from the past forward in time to talk about their lives. Today, we will be talking with the famous British naturalist, Charles Darwin.
We will be asking Charles questions about his famous book, On the Origin of Species, and what it was like to make it. He will also be asking us a few questions. He wants to know what people today think about his book.
Here he is now! Please welcome Charles Darwin. Charles, do you need a microphone?
Thank you.
It's nice to have you here, Charles.
Hi, Paige and Rachel. It's nice to be here. I'm very interested in finding out more about what happened with my book in the future.
To start out, why don't you tell us a few things about yourself?
Okay, well, I will start off by saying I was born in 1809, just to give you an idea of what time period I came from. In 1831, I was the naturalist that took a voyage on the HMS Beagle. It was my findings from that journey that I used to write On the Origin of Species.
What was it like collecting information for this book?
Coming up with my theory was a lot of fun, but took a long time. I was aboard the HMS Beagle for 5 years, going around from the Galapagos Islands, South America, Africa, and Australia. My curiosity is what really kept me going.
What new idea did your book bring to the scientific world?
It is important to realize that I didn't come up with the idea of evolution. I came up with a new mechanism called natural selection. Natural selection is the process by which traits become more or less common in a population due to consistent effects upon the survival or reproduction of their bearers.
Did you think natural selection would change the biology world like it did?
Well, when I was drafting On the Origin of Species, I really believed in what I was writing about, and I had the scientific evidence for it. It helped the majority of people see that there was scientific evidence behind evolution and that it wasn't just made up. Although, at the time, many people were very religious, they started to support me and other naturalists.
You talked briefly about religion in that last answer. Was it hard to come up with a book that you knew some people would reject due to religion?
I was very confident in my work, so I never really worried about that too much. Before I started studying natural science, I went to medical school. I dropped out of that to go to Christ College at Cambridge University to study to be a clergyman in the Church of England. While studying there, I became friends with a mineralogist, and he influenced me to study science. After my findings, I knew that I had scientific evidence to back me up, so I wasn't nervous about publishing my book.
Wow, nice answer. Now that we have information on what it was like back in 1860, I think Charles has a few questions for us.
Yes, I do. Since we're on the topic of rejecting my theory, I would like to ask, do people still reject my ideas because of religion like they used to?
Today, it is the same as it was before with religion. Everyone has their own opinion on evolution, whether it is based on religion or not. Some people accept and others reject your theory of evolution by way of natural selection. Also, today, scientists have found out new things that have proven different things about evolution.
Oh, interesting. What kind of new things have scientists discovered about evolution and natural selection?
Your book did two things. Showed evidence of evolution happened and is happening, and explained the mechanism of natural selection. Now, evolution is not seen as a theory, but more as a fact. Although the evolution part still holds true, natural selection being the only mechanism for evolution is now being challenged.
Yeah! After the breakthrough with genetics and population biology, they came up with the neo-Darwinian theory of evolution. It recognized the importance of mutation and variation within a population. It is said now that many other mechanisms, in addition to natural selection, make up evolution. These current ideas are called modern synthesis.
That's so wonderful! How does this idea of modern synthesis differ from my ideas?
There are three things that differ from your ideas. The first is that there is more than one mechanism of evolution, which we touched on before. One of these things may be as important as natural selection, random genetic drift. The second thing is recognizing the characteristics inherited by genes and the variation within a population is due to having more than one allele of a gene. The third difference is the idea that speciation is usually due to the gradual accumulation of small genetic changes.
Looks like science has come a long way. I'd love to learn more about it sometime. Science is nothing like it was when I originally wrote the book. I wonder what ever happened to that book.
Oh, I heard the other day that the original copy sold for $170,000 after being found on the bookshelf at a family's home in Oxford.
That's crazy. That's a ton of money for my book. How exciting.
Yeah, that is exciting. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have for today.
Yeah, it's time to send Charles Darwin back to where he came from. Thanks for joining us, Charles. See you later.
Thanks for having me. Goodbye.
page, she disappeared. Howdy! Okay. Hi everyone, I'm Rachel.
You can't do this. I cannot give this to you.
Come on. To start out, why don't you tell us a few things about yourself?
Why is that so funny? I don't get it.
Today, it is the same as it was. Today, it is the same as it was before religion. Everyone has their own opinion on before religion. By way of natural selection. Also, by a natural selection. Some people accept and others reject your theory of evolution by way of
God. I was really gonna roll with that. Take five, everyone.
By way of natural selection.
Disregard what your fears.
Everybody, compose yourself to me.
Goodbye.
Signing off.
Over and out.
Howdy, y'all.